is for the Proving Ground Pro Tag Team Championship.
Welcome to Pro Wrestling Central Illinois this week. I am the Mad Conservative Crime Fighter here at Proving Ground Pro at Southeast High School. The Alpha Class, the PGP Tag Team Champions, taking on Blake Belakis and Nate Redwing, the Carnival Club. As Danny Adams gives a shove to Blake Belakis. And it looks like Blake and Nate are not getting along here. As Belakis charges Alpha Class and gets a back body drop for his troubles and outside as Paco Gonzalez goes flying through the ropes and takes out Blake Belakis. Belakis tossed back in, Danny Adams flying knee. And two count. From Danny Adams. And there's a tag to Nate Redwing. Swing a miss, boot. Redwing was a clubbing forearm to the back of the head of Danny Adams. Pickup. And the Future Star Award winner from Missouri Wrestling Revival gets a power slam on Danny Adams, but Blake Belakis tags himself back in and only gets a one count. I don't even know why he even bothered. Go for a quick cover like that. Especially early on in this match. And there's a leg to the face from Danny Adams. Paco Gonzalez comes back in. Alpha Class. Hip toss. Crucifix cover, set up for a drop kick. And Paco only gets a two count. Come on! Danny Adams, now known as Adam Ryan in the National Wrestling League. Paco Gonzalez, now known as JV Torres. And Nate Redwing is known as Lakota Red Cloud. National Wrestling League on Thursday, every other Thursday in the St. Louis area.
Now he's going to be in the ring.
Blake Belakis. His dams in the wrong part of town. Nate Redwing jumps in, yanks down Danny Adams. And Blake Belakis with a chokehold. And there's a tag. Nate Redwing comes in, does damage on the millennial. Only a two. Adam Ryan now teaming with Jake Parnell, now known as Jackie Lee Botch. A leg drop from Redwing. And a two count.
Two count.
Alpha Class held the PGP Tag Team titles for quite a long time, survived the challenge from the Hooligans, and had another successful defense, the main event of the most recent PGP event in Iliopolis. By the way, get well wishes go out to Mason Cutter of the Hooligans, who suffered a broken leg in Daytona, Ohio over the weekend.
Come on, Paco, you're not helping him.
Proving Ground Pro will be returning to Havana, Illinois on April the 18th at the Lawford Theater. As Danny Adams catches Belakis with that elbow. But now he just got himself caught. Nope. Sunset flip. But Belakis with a flying knee. Gets only a two count. Wrestling shows happening this weekend. IWA Unlimited is running, well, every Tuesday night, and now New Way Pro seemingly running every Friday night in February in Terre Haute. They're doing Fight TV tapings. There's going to be a lot of chatter about Fight TV in the next several weeks. Seems that everybody's been getting on the bandwagon. New Way Pro will be taping matches for Fight TV. Southern Illinois Championship Wrestling will be airing its program that they already air on cable down there on the Fight TV channel, in addition to putting it on YouTube. Today, Abs with a flying knee, but backs into the corner to tag in.
Hurry up!
Like Belakis, and Day Abs can't quite reach Paco Gonzalez. Kicks him away though! Tag to Paco! Swing a miss! Day, or Paco, flying forearm in the corner. Gonzalez, another forearm in the corner. Paco! Nope. Missed the fifth one, but gets the enziguri. Paco Gonzalez flying. Tornado DDT. Oh, it was a two count. Belakis was even asking the ref. While Nate Redwing circles the ring and pulls off Danny Adams to prevent any sort of tag. And Redwing tries to flatten Paco in the corner, and looks like Carnival Club is going to try to end this now. Belakis with its inverted Death Valley driver! And Redwing comes flying off the ropes, although I think he lost his footing and didn't get the impact he wanted. He was going to try and splash it from the second rope, but he slipped. Just did not connect with it like he should have. That may give Alpha Class a bit of a break, but there's a boot to the face and another boot. Dams tries to come in, but look at this. Oh! Uppercut to the back of the head! While Nate Redwing making the throat slash to the cameras, Dams comes in for the save. And now Blake Belakis looking for the palm strike. And he nails his own partner.
Roll up!
Paco rolls him up! Three count! Belakis! Pump strikes his own partner! As Paco Gonzalez slips out of Nate Redwing's grip. He gets struck in the face and quick roll up, three count, it's over. It's awesome. It's awesome. Adams, your victors in this contest. Relatively short time, too. 6 minutes and 40 seconds, and the Carnival Club have to go back to the drawing board as the things have not gone well for this tag team. Kept up with the information going on with Birmingham Pro. Dams will be continuing the tag with Jake Parnell down at National Wrestling League. Other new names as Paco Gonzalez going to be going into singles action as JV Torres.
There you go.
Down at the Casa Loma Ballroom in a couple of weeks.
Hey, Blake, you messed up!
You are the biggest man on TGP, and you came to win the stinking tag team title with my help! I am the best wrestler in TGP! I carried this company on my back for all these years for you to come out here!
Belakis being a sore loser here.
You're not a hardcore. You are not a
he'll slap around a guy like Nate Redwing, because he'll do that to you. Nate Redwing, big, powerful individual, ended up being the final Metro Pro Wrestling Central States champion. And Redwing, a.k.a. Lakota Red Cloud, sends a message to Blake Belakis: I don't need you. You may not need me, but I don't need you either. I got my own fish to fry in. Who's this?
Who's this?
A man in a white hat. Oh, that's Stephen King. Stephen King putting a flower on Blake Belakis, noting that the Carnival Club is over. Belakis throws the flower at King. The chainsaw. And Belakis wants some of Stephen King here. And he goes right after him. Oh yeah, that's gonna work. And a kick to between the uprights! Stephen King puts him in between the uprights! The Carnival Club looks like they are kicking Blake Belakis out of the Carnival Club entirely. Powerbomb! And Stephen King lays Blake Belakis to waste. Boy, Belakis had a bad last half of 2016 as nothing went right with him.
Stephen King, yeah.
The last half of the year. Well, let's hope. Well, maybe 2017 things will go differently for him, but for now, Belakis laid waste and just absolutely embarrassed. All right, we're going to go to the weekend schedule. We'll be right back. Ladies and gentlemen, if you've ever wanted to be a professional wrestler, here's your chance now. Head to the Pinfall Academy, located on the square in Auburn, Illinois at 101 North 4th Street. They start you off with cardio exercise and teach basic wrestling and performance techniques. You can even learn to be a referee, manager, or announcer. For more information, call 217-891-4679. Pinfall Academy, where the new crop begins.
Yeah!
All right. Tag team action here, and the winner of this match will get a future title shot against the Alpha Class, who retained the tag titles against the Carnival Club at the beginning of the program, first half. I do want to mention the team of Ovirload and Draconis came in with a firearm. That's Southeast High School, and pretty much any school across the country is a gun-free zone. So these two should have known better. Bringing a gun to the school grounds, that's going to get them arrested. Draconis and Ovirload from the northern regions of this area. Calling themselves the Curse. Why they call themselves a curse. Curse wrestling regularly for Vanguard Wrestling All-Star Alliance, which was recently purchased by AEW. So AEW is kind of a bigger deal of late. Curse! Double hip tosses Sage Phillips. Ovirload off the ropes. Leg drop, splash combination, cover. And only a two. Only a two count. Now the other team, the Hysteria, comes in from Indiana. As Ovirload's pretty much have his way with Sage Phillips thus far in this contest. Only a two. Cole Radrick on the outside of the ring. He's got that shoulder taped up. Phillips and Radrick wrestle regularly for IWA Mid-South down in the Louisville, Kentucky area. They have to run their shows on the Indiana side of the river, as they've been pretty much banished from Kentucky. Bloomington, Indiana. The team known as Hysteria. Pretty much their wrestling home at this point is Emerge Wrestling. And Draconis with an Undertaker-like maneuver drops that sledge off the top as Ovirload flies off the top rope in an arm drag. Sage Phillips in big trouble here. Shows this weekend. Mentioned National Wrestling League on the 9th. Of course, if you're watching this on Thursday night on Channel 4, well, the show is pretty much over at this point.
Uh-oh.
Oh, flying!
Fail!
Neckbreaker. I think he was going for something more than that, but a backcracker. I guess he was going for a flying stunner, but don't know if he got all they wanted. Flying elbow from Cole Radrick. And only a two. Other shows happening this weekend. Mid-Missouri Wrestling Alliance. South Broadway Flag Club, as Cole Radrick is choking Ovirload on the middle rope. Central Illinois Pro Wrestling returns to Kincaid, Illinois. It's the makeup from January from the ice storm of the century that really didn't materialize. And Sage Phillips comes in. There was not even a tag. Draconis is in the corner as the referee's trying to get him out. Wrestling over everything on the 12th in Swansea, Illinois on a Sunday. And the 18th, Midwest Impact Pro at the Mount Pulaski American Legion Hall. It's not the doggone holy havoc crap. SICW at East Cairn Della Community Center. It's another Fight TV taping there. And Proving Ground Pro returns to the Lawford Theater in Havana, Illinois on the 18th. Sage Phillips rakes the eyes of Overlord right through the mask. The first Glory Pro Wrestling Show, that's a promotion run by Michael Elgin in conjunction with Alpha Wrestling out of Canada. Knights of Columbus Hall in Olden, Illinois on the 19th. Then the last weekend of February, Pitfall Wrestling Association with another Fight TV taping. I believe it's third since they taped Jacksonville and Springfield. Those 2 weeks of January, splash in the corner. Sage Phillips with a snapmare out of the corner and an enziguri. A cover. And Draconis breaks it up for Wrestling Association of Lanphier High School on the 25th for retaliation and more shenanigans going on there, but save that for another week. And this came out of nowhere. Galley Lucha Libre comes in from Chicago to wrestle at the Lincoln Springs Center on February the 18th in Bloomington, Illinois. Cole Raddick texts himself back in, going for a suplex. Drops him, cover, and referee counts two. Anyway, for Fight TV, it is a downloadable app to your iPhone or your Android. You want to download to your smartphone or your tablet and use it in conjunction with a Chromecast device. I believe it also works with Roku TV. Basically, you go on the Fight TV app, look for the show you want, then stream it to your Chromecast so you can watch it on your television, big screen TV, flat screen TV, smart TV. It works pretty good with the Chromecast as the Hysteria double teams Overlord in the corner. And Draconis breaks it up before there's even a count. Cole Raddick talking trash with the audience here at Southeast High School. This is way back in October. Well, and Hysteria gets rammed together, and then a flying knee takes out both men by Overlord. And Overlord needs to crawl in to the other side of the ring, but the referee needs to get one member of Hysteria out. They've been in this double teaming the entire time here. Overlord gets back to his feet, jumps over to Draconis. Firelord Draconis tags in. Nails both members of Hysteria. Curtis with a splash in the corner. No splash. Both members of Hysteria duck. And Draconis flies out. But Overlord back in the ring. Charges. Swing and a miss. Double kick to the knee. And kicks him in the head, but Draconis comes back in the ring and dumps out Sage Phillips. As Draconis chops Cole Raddick. Cole Raddick in trouble. Oh, look at that, a double stunner. I can't believe it, Sage Phillips takes down Draconis, but Overlord charges with a kick to the head. Duck under from Sage Phillips. Overlord breaks that waist lock. Grabs Sage, picks him up. Brainbuster! Well, apparently it's not the legal man. As I don't know how the referee knows who the legal man is. I guess it's Draconis. Well, Overlord's not the legal man, it's Draconis. That's about all I could gather. The referee would not allow a count by Overlord or on Overlord. Guess it's Radrick and Draconis. Pull Radrick back to his feet, but he's stumbling around. And Sage Phillips circles around the ring. Draconis stomping Cole Radrick. Now the Curse kind of regrouping here, deciding what they're going to do next. Sends him into the ropes. Overlord charges! Suicide dive onto Sage Phillips. People at ringside having to scatter. Draconis looking to do something here, maybe pull out his partner. Oh, Radrick kicked him in the head. Here comes Cole. Moonsault takes out both men. Overlord is up partner. Draconis, however, still in the ring.
Oh, no.
Look out! Suicide dive takes out the Hysteria. The Curse has Hysteria in trouble. Sage Phillips put back in the ring. I don't know if the ref even knows who the legal men are now. Lock. Sage Phillips. Northlight suplex. Still not the legal man. Yes, the referee does know who the legal men are. Draconis in. Let's see if he counts a fall on Sage Phillips. Pick up. Drops it face first. This is called Radrick.
Finish him.
Radrick outside. Overlord going to the top rope. He needs to tag him. Well, I guess that would be considered a tag. Rocket launcher. Nope. Not tag, but cover. And the Curse is victorious over the team of Sage Phillips and Cole Radrick. I guess I've been mispronouncing his name the entire match. Sorry. I don't have the time to re-record this. Winners by pinfall in 12 minutes and 40 seconds. Supreme Ground Pro will be returned to the Lawford Theater on the 18th. In Havana, as the Curse just secured themselves a tag team title shot in the future. But I want to wish everybody thank you for tuning in this edition of PWCI this week. I'm the Mad Conservative Crime Fighter. We'll see you next time.